we think that the reason the world is still unprepared to fight this pandemic against future ones is because the current generation needle vaccines are very narrow, which is the past variant, right? Mm. But our vaccine, because it activates your mucosal immunity in the mouth, in the nose, has a much broader spectrum of activity. So we've shown in both our clinical trials that our vaccine mounts a very broad immune response against Wuhan, Delta, Omicron, and other variants. So we believe that our vaccine doesn't need to be changed. It's already future-proof. You know, it can potentially protect you against future variants.
Hello, Andre.
Hi, how are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. How about you?
Good, very good, very good.
Okay. First of all, could you tell us about this progressive method? What is Vaxar trying to achieve it?
Sure, sure. So again, very happy to be here in Bali at the G20. We came here to discuss how our next generation vaccine, which comes as a pill, can completely transform the vaccination paradigm globally and can make the world better prepared to fight pandemics, this one and the next one. So our vaccine for COVID-19, as well as others, come as a pill like this. Mm-hmm. It's room temperature stable, so doesn't need refrigeration. And you can vaccinate an entire country much faster than by needle, because you can, you know, just send it to people, and with just a glass of water, they can take it. No pain, no needles.
Yeah.
And we believe this is the future.
Wow, very nice. And how about the progress for the trials recently?
Sure, sure. So the first thing I want to say is that this is the first and only pill vaccine that has been proven in clinical trials in humans to be as good as a leading injectable vaccine against another respiratory virus, which is flu. So we've already shown that this vaccine, our vaccine, can work as well as something you need to take as an injection against flu, which is very notable. And then we started clinical trials with for COVID a couple of years ago, and now we just finished our phase 2 clinical trials against COVID with very encouraging results.
Okay. Many vaccines seem effective for the initial variant of the Wuhan SARS-CoV-2, but now more and more variants are emerging. How does Vaxar update its biotechnology to deal with other variants that may continue to appear?
That's a fantastic question. We think that the reason the world is still unprepared to fight this pandemic against future ones is because the current generation needle vaccines are very narrow. As you said, they are only good against the variant for which they were designed, which is the past variant, right? But our vaccine, because it activates your mucosal immunity in the mouth, in the nose, has a much broader spectrum of activity. So we've shown in both our clinical trials that our vaccine mounts a very broad immune response against Wuhan, Delta, Omicron, and other variants. So we believe that our vaccine doesn't need to be changed. It's already future-proof, you know, it can potentially protect you against future variants, which would be significant.
Okay. What challenges have you found?
Another great question. I think the main challenge is similar to perhaps what Tesla had to face when trying to tell people, you know, electric cars are better than internal combustion engine. We live in a needle-centric world, right? So everybody thinks what we need is more needle vaccines. So all the resources were directed towards the two mRNA vaccines, J&J vaccine, and so on. And that made it very difficult for us to progress to clinical trials, to manufacture our vaccine, and it actually slowed us down significantly. So that's why we realized, okay, we need to tell people the real story. We need to tell people that they're investing in the old technology, you know? It's like now we are all using cell phones, and I'm telling you, let's invest in landline phones, right? Those are the past. So that's, I think, the main challenge has been to tell people there is a better way, and you need to think differently about it.
Okay. Indonesia presidency for G20 has formed pandemic fund and managed to gather some amount from G20 partners around $1 million.
I think it's a good step. I think it tells you that countries like Indonesia and others around the world, they are very aware that the current generation vaccines are lacking, are very limited, that more needs to be done. I think it's also a step in the right direction, because what we've seen in the pandemic is that the key to moving fast is a partnership between public and private, right? Do I think that's the best step or the only step we need to take? I don't know, but again, I think it's a step forward.
Okay.
So look, I think it's good that people want to do more, and Indonesia has taken a leading role here. Again, what I'm concerned about is that many people who come from the industry, come from Pfizer, come from J&J and so on, they just think needle. So they're just going to want to invest more into the same thing. And instead of exploring other technologies, right? This is so disruptive. It could change the way we fight pandemics. And I think we should be able to have a broader view and explore more innovative options. Also, what's good for the US is not good for Indonesia. You know, the rich world, rich economies, they have capabilities like cold chain storage and so on, and medical systems and medical staff that a country like Indonesia doesn't. So I think we should invest more in developing solutions that are global, right?
Okay. Does Vaxar have any approaches in a medical ecosystem in Indonesia?
Yes, well, that's why I'm here. I was invited here by the representatives of the Indonesian government, by the chairman of Kadin, exactly to do this, to explore ways in which we can, Vaxart and Indonesia could make Indonesia be part or central to the discussion about next generation vaccines and about the future of pandemic preparedness. So we want to explore how we can potentially develop our oral pill vaccine in Indonesia for Indonesians and kind of customize the solution here, potentially even manufacture it here. And so Vaxart would love to be able to partner with a leading developing country to showcase how this solution can actually be most beneficial for developing countries.
So this explain to you come to Indonesia. Why you come to in Indonesia but not maybe to Malaysia, Singapore? Or why Vaxart to come to Indonesia?
Well, I think I came to Indonesia because the Indonesian politicians and business people I met, I think they have the vision that we have, which is we need dramatic transformation here, we need innovation. And so our technology really resonated with them, and they invited me here to the G20, to the V20, to discuss how we can work together to make this a reality.
And, okay, and last question, what are your plan here to future time in Indonesia?
Yeah, so as I said before, we plan on discussing more how we can potentially do clinical trials here in Indonesia, how we can develop the oral pill vaccine here in Indonesia, potentially how we can manufacture it here for use not only here in Indonesia but also regionally.
Okay, thank you for your time and your explanation, Andrew. Nice to meet you.
Thank you so much for having me.